So welcome to this short presentation on using SQUID and time restrictions as a proxy server. I'm using a very simple installation of OpenSUSE 9.3, and of course that does mean I have a very simple graphical environment. The first thing I need to work on is gaining root access running the SU command. The SQUID is already installed, and let me just show you the configuration file as it starts. Looking immediately in SQUID and then the squid.conf. And goodness me, look at this, we've got 3,500 lines, most of which are comments. So let's make a backup of this. So I'm going to move through into the etc SQUID directory. We're just going to copy squid.conf to squid.conf. Original ORIG. So that leaves me with my original configuration and then the backup. What I'm going to do is overwrite the conf file, so I'm going to strip out those unwanted lines with grep. But the documentation is still going to be left in the original file. So grep minus cd. I'm going to take out lines that begin with a hash. I'm also going to remove lines that are empty, so caret dollar from my original file. Let's append the greater than, so we send the output to overwrite the original squid.conf. And now, of course, running the previous less command, you can see we've got from 3,500 lines to 35 lines, which is absolutely incredible. We're now ready to edit that file. Essentially, only the local host is allowed access through to my proxy server. So I'm going to add an access control list rule that will allow my 172 network, my local network, to gain access. I'll give you the network rules together. So where it says ACL all source 000, I'm going to create one called local net. And we'll say 172.17.0.0, that's 16. I'll do it with cider notation, which I've forgotten the source tag. So that then puts in a tag that I can use in the access control list. We scroll down to the rules that will allow this to go through. So we've got HTTP access rules. And I'm going to insert a line, making sure it's above any of the deny lines. HTTP access allow local net, which is just defined. If we hit it, I'll save this change. Currently my SQUID server won't be running, so I'll start the SQUID server. RC SQUID start. Now the distributions you'd use service space SQUID start, but in SUSE they create symbolic links. And to make sure it starts at boot time, I'm doing a chk config, check config, minus a, SQUID. It's going to start in line number 3. I'm going to swap through to my workstation. The workstation I've been using previously, but let me just go through and show you the internet options. So qa.com is my homepage, but importantly I want to look at the connections. So go to the LAN settings. And I've configured the IP address of the proxy server, and I'm using the default port of 3120. I haven't changed the HTTP port in the SQUID configuration. So we should be allowed access at the moment. So if I refresh this web page, even though I do not have a default gateway, my only access to the internet is through the proxy server, and then I'm able to see the web page. So where this becomes useful is perhaps being able to put some time restrictions in. So I'm going to go back into my configuration, and I'm going to put in an access control list tag for time instead of source this time. So ACL, I can call it anything I like, so I'm going to call this weekday. So type time, and we've got a capital D which represents days of the week, Monday through to Friday. And then from 1800-2100, so from 6 to 9 in the evening, obviously you can choose the appropriate times. So your kids can only access in those 3 hours during the week. We can then add it to my local net rule. So we can say we have to be from the local net and it has to be a weekday. So escape and then to exit. Restart my SQUID server. But because it's not between those times, it is a weekday, but it's not 6 o'clock yet, as I try and access the page, and then refuse access. Now, stopping access during the week is one thing, but you might also need to allow your kids access perhaps a little bit more during the weekend. So we do something slightly different here. I've already amended the weekday time to be 1300 just so we can test if it's working now. I copy and paste that line and create a weekend time. So A for Saturday and S for Sunday. Remember D was Monday through to Friday. A and S then represents the weekend. And we'll say from 12 o'clock to 1400 hours. But we want two times available, the two time slots on the weekend. So we cut and paste this line, or copy and paste this line, and we add in and the 1800 to 2100 hours. So your children will be able to access the internet at these two time slots, so between 12 and 2 and 6 and 9 in the evening. Of course, we need to then go through and add this to our access control list. So then I cut and paste this line, or copy and paste this line. The local net is allowed, not just on weekdays, so if it's not a weekday, you then pass on to the next day, and then we check to see if it's a weekend. If it matches any of the times at the weekend and the weekend days, then we'll be allowed. So then we save the changes. We restart the SQUID server. Sometimes I do find that I need to stop the SQUID server a couple of times, just a little time out issue. But once it has successfully stopped, then I'll start the SQUID server. And then test it from the client. We should be able to access now because it's a weekday and it's between 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And of course, I'm not going to test it for the weekend. So, I do hope this has been useful. There will be a follow on using SquidGuard to control content through the proxy server. And as usual, please visit us on our website for my YouTube channel.